From the Groove Remains production team studios in the Netherlands, my name is Mix Master G and welcome to this tutorial. My mission is not to sell you as many apps as I can, no, my mission is to educate and teach you about collection management and conversion for DJs, so you save yourself more time for the fun and creative part of being a DJ. This tutorial is about something that is plaguing conversion between DJ software for a long time, namely the shift in queues, loops and beat grids that can occur when you go from one DJ software into another. This shift will only happen with compressed audio. And compressed audio we all know as an MP3 or an Apple audio compressed file, an AAC file. Shifts will not occur with lossless files. So that means if you've got FLAC, AFF, WAVs, you won't see any shifts when you convert between DJ software. Another misconception is that when shifts occur, the encoder should be bad and that the audio quality will be bad. That is not the case. If a shift occurs, it doesn't say anything about how good or bad the audio quality will be. I've seen shifts happening with beatport tracks, which sounded amazing. So one thing doesn't have to do anything with the other. Using compressed audio involves using two pieces of software, namely an encoder that compresses the audio data into a smaller file, which actually makes the MP3 file out of the audio data, and a decompressor or decoder that makes the compressed data back to audible data. And here lays the problem, because there is no such thing as a single decoder or a single encoder. There are a gazillion encoders, all with their own specifications, and there are a gazillion decoders. Each DJ software uses its very own decoder, and each file can be produced with its very own encoder. While the decoder is of course static for every DJ software, Traktor has one decoder for MP3s, Rekordbox has one single decoder for MP3s, you never know where the track originated from, so it might be encoded with a lot of different encoders, and that is where the problem is. And because this is such an important issue, I've thought about a metaphor to make this less technical and easier to understand, and I came up with one. Think about a cue point or a beat grid or a loop as a point in seconds on the timeline of a track. And that is exactly what happens in most DJ software. It's just a point at a certain time within the track. Now, in order to have different DJ software, I came up with this piece of paper. This is Rekordbox. You see three tracks there. This is Serato with, again, three tracks. And those three tracks represent three different tracks made with different encoders. And I got encoders as well, namely three different measurement instruments or ruler units, if you like. As you can see, all different. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to set at 5 centimeters and 10 centimeters in each track, in each line, a little dot. And in an ideal world, those dots should be aligned. However, you will see that is not the case. And I will also show you why that is not happening. And then you immediately understand why different encoders make different cue points at a different time. And let's start out with encoder one, this ruler. And like I said, we give it a cue point at the 5 and the 10 centimeter mark. So that is right here, and that is right here. We do the same thing with this ruler unit. We give it again at the 5. And at the 10 centimeters, a little dot. And then finally, we use the big one, this one. And we give it at 5 centimeters. One there and one there. Now, if you look closer, you will see that those cues don't align. Look, if I take this little unit and move it around, you see that they don't really align with each other. However, if we measure any of those points, you see they are all 5 centimeters apart. So they are properly set. The difference is the zero point on the ruler units. If we take the first encoder right here and we add the second one to it and we align the edges of them, you see that the zero points don't really align with each other. The same with the big one. The zero point doesn't align with any of the other ruler units, which means that because the zero is different, the actual cues will shift, and they will shift by the same amount, namely the difference between the zero points. Now, if we do the same thing with racket box, and again, I do exactly the same thing right here at the 5 and at the 10. And then we take a different encoder, line it up at the 5 and at the 10. And then we take the last encoder. Those things are always very dangerous. They can cut your fingers in two. They are very sharp at the edge, so you always have to be careful with those. There and there. And again, you see those shift. But if we overlap the Serato with the racket box, you'll see that they shift even more if we align the edges again. And why is that? Because the zero point, the very big vertical line, the zero point within the software, is changed. And that is the decoder of the software changing. So you can now understand that those shifts will happen. It's just a matter of how you measure, a matter of what you use to produce the cue points, to measure the cue points with. Now, as long as you stay within the same DJ software, there is no problem, because you never set your cue point at 5 seconds and at 10 seconds from the baseline, from the zero point, the vertical line. No, you set it at a given transient within the track, and that can be a kick or a snare usually. And that means, as long as you stay in the same software, the same decoder is used. So even if the tracks are made with different encoders, it really doesn't matter, because the same decoder will always get the same results. The problem begins when you go to other DJ software, because not only the vertical line will be changed then, but also you need to know how different encoded files are handled by the particular decoder of the DJ software. That is why I equipped my tools with that little checkbox, check for MP3 encoder compensation, which makes conversion longer, because the tool needs to find the encoder used to produce the MP3 track, and that can only be done by analyzing the actual track, so that takes some time to perform, but that gives you the best results for the conversions. At the beginning, I told you there are two reasons for the shifts in cues and loops. One is the technical one, and we just discussed that. The other one is more subjective, and personally, I don't find it a problem, but there is a difference there, and I'm going to dive into that right now with you. Here we've got a track, or actually a screen cut from a track. It's a track Boom by Tiesto, and I set a cue point within different DJ software at exactly the same place. Now, this is the tractor waveform. I'm a tractor guy, and this is exactly why I am a tractor guy, because it is very easy to interpret this waveform. You see where the transients are, you see exactly where the boom starts, so there is no discussion about that. Now, let's compare that to the one that Virtual DJ makes. This is the same track with the same cue point. The magnification is slightly different, because not every software allows the same level of magnification, but I try to make it as close as possible. And you can see those waveforms are different. And what always bugs me within Virtual DJ is this. You see right here this little vertical line. That vertical line is the beat grid of Virtual DJ. That is what Virtual DJ said the beat grid is. And you can see I had to set the cue in advance of the actual beat grid. And even more, there is more artifacts in front of the actual transient that you can see going on. So it's always hard to see what point should that be exactly. Then we can have a look at Serato, which yet gives you another interpretation. Again, different magnification possibilities. This is the highest in Serato. It comes kind of close to what Rector does. It doesn't come close to Virtual DJ at all. Then we can have a look at Rekordbox. This is Rekordbox, and Rekordbox and Traktor are kind of the same if it comes to their WAV forms. I like to keep it monochrome because the moment I go to the blobby WAV forms, I cannot make head or toes of them. And then finally, we've got Engine Prime. And that is always a mystery how to interpret this one. Because you can see right here that usually you would think that the transient would be more to the right, because that's just the building up of the actual bass drum there. But no, it should be there because that sounds the best. As with everything, as a DJ, use your ears to see where they actually should be. Don't rely on your eyes, because as you can see right here, the same track, exactly the same track, gives you a very different looking waveform with very different properties. The cues will act differently on it. So use your ears and correct whatever is necessary. That is all I wanted to tell you about Q loop and beatgrid shifts that can occur when you convert between DJ software. There is another tutorial right above my head where I explain what you can do to help me to make my tools even better and to compensate for more Q and loop shifts if they happen to occur. For now, thank you for watching. If you like my video, don't forget to give it the thumbs up. Subscribe to my YouTube channel so you get alerted when I've got new videos out. For now, Mixmaster G signing off.